All right, what is up, folks? 7:30. We are in Friday night. You know what that means? Panhandle Surf Fishing Report. Actually, fishing report. It's not really, really surf fishing. We do a little bit of everything.
We do a little bit of everything.
I'm trying to share this now. Why does it always give me trouble? Share.
I don't know. You're not popping up on the old live stream there, Sir Smitty Surf Fishing.
Yeah, I know.
You do it through your
phone? Yeah, share now. Now I'm trying to share it. Share. Come on.
Share it now. Yeah, I got it now.
Share to my profile?
No, it's on your Smitty. No. It took a minute. It's on the delay.
That's not where I want to go. I need to go to a group.
Sorry, everybody, because you know how it is in the beginning here, because this is how we do things.
Exactly.
Oh, 4 comments already, and I haven't even checked them yet. It's got to be Jacob. Jacob, we're
gotta be
on time. We are not early.
No, we are on time. We got to get it over to Panhandle, though.
I can move it if you want.
Yeah, go ahead. Move it over there, Demo.
Sending. All right, bring us in. Get us going.
There we go. There we go, folks. We should be good now. 5 comments going. Yeah, Jacob.
Yep, he got it.
We got to get better now. There's a delay. So once we go from StreamYard and it starts videoing,
yeah,
we got a 30-second timer in there to hopefully give me time to switch it over. But the interactions between everything is kind of slow. But we're there, and we're almost on time.
Almost.
So, almost. Right. Tonight's episode, episode number 4. So thank you, everybody, for joining in. If you guys, first time joining in and watching, if you don't know who we are, I'm Mike Smith, Smitty Surf Fishing, and my co-host is...
Hey. Demo from Finding Demo Surf Fishing Podcast. Welcome aboard, everybody. It's going to be a good episode. We got some fun stuff coming for you this week.
Yeah, it's going to be great. We got Captain Bill back with us from E6 Inshore Fishing Adventures, doing our inshore report. And for our surf fishing report, we got Mr. Blaine Roberts, Perdido Blaine.
Perdido Blaine!
Over there in Perdido, Florida, fishing Alabama, Florida line. So we should have some good reports. I've seen reports on Facebook from both of those guys, and they've been out catching them this week.
Yeah, they have. And there's been some awesome catches reported by all of you, definitely on Panhandle Surf Fishing. And we've seen some really cool things we will definitely get to tonight. And it's going to be fun. So, yeah, stick around. As always, hey, don't forget. Good evening, Chris Florence. How are you? Welcome to the show. Share these out. By all means, this is a public broadcast. This can go out to all your friends. It's a public stream. So share it on out. Comments are welcome. We like to be interactive. We will always happily try to answer questions. The answer might not, you might not like it. It might get weird, but hey, we do things live. Justin, what's up, partner?
Justin, what's up, buddy? Great catch today, by the way. Yeah.
What do you finish? Was finish what? One pump, one white? No, mess of whiting or one whiting? Was it 1-1-1? I can't remember. I think he finished. He said he finished on an evil catfish that boggled a couple lines, actually.
What up, Mr. Cliff Gardner?
Cliff in Tejas.
That's right. He'll be in town soon.
He will. The poor guy. He doesn't even know what's going to happen.
But I think. From what I saw today out there, our conversation from last week was spot on.
Yeah.
And if you didn't watch us last week, we had a great discussion on where the pompano are. You can go back and watch that. It's out there. Give it a look. It was a great conversation. Mr. Cliff Gardner jumped in with us and provided some great info along with everybody else. And I think we were right. You know, sun shines on a dog's butt every now and then.
Yep. Broken watches right twice a day. Yep. So, yeah, I mean, 1 week off. I mean, it's kind of crazy that kind of worked that way. The fall run has become a borderline winter run. And it's just been, I'm just shocked. I really, that's the best way to put it. I really did not expect it to be this far behind. But the water temperature was all kind of messed up. So, I think, I guess we'll spoil it a little bit. We'll go off the close a little. A couple limits have been found. I mean, we've had one limit reported today in Navarre with a 6 pompano catch. And G2, old Jordan, caught his limit over in Hamilton.
Yeah, I'll be bringing up some of his photos later. They're
nice.
Man, Alabama's been on them, which only made sense that they'd be coming this way soon.
Yep. Jacob, as soon as I get out and fish, unfortunately, I have been a horrible angler and I have been working a little bit too much.
Speaking of catfish, huh?
12 inches. As soon as I get it, man, 12 inches, it's going to happen. Cliff, yeah, you're right. Carl, welcome back. Welcome to the show. Welcome to your first time on.
Mr. Phelps.
First time caller, long time watcher.
Heck yeah. And, thanks for.
Cliff, no one too. Jeremiah, good evening. Welcome. Jeremiah got out today as well. Lies. That's what I do, man. I mean, not lies. All right. So, as I digress, what do we got for weather coming up, bud? We got some
weather. That's what I forgot to put up. Yeah, so the next, we got rain coming in tomorrow. Should be raining all day. Rain overnight Sunday, but clearing up on Sunday. Winds should start shifting out of the north, northeast, which will blow it flat a little bit, blow the rain out of here. And then not real high temps either. We should be like in the mid 60s. I don't have that tab up right now. Hang on, let me pull it up real quick.
And we've also got some good surf today. I was down at Fort Pickens doing a job. I know that Beach Buzz was out there while I was working. Surf looked great. He had a couple of catches. He reported a pomp, a mess of whiting, and the waves were looking to be about two to three, but they were tightly packed on the cadence. So keep that in mind with the surf one. We know, yeah, size is one thing, but that tight packing is really what kind of messes stuff up. And I'm going to steal a thing from, I do need that travel rod. I'll get myself in trouble with that, Justin. I'll never get a job done. But with all that one, we talked about it when I was doing that podcast with Chip. You know, if you throw that line out there on those heavy surf days, little tidbit for you here. If you haven't listened to the podcast, which I'd love to tease it, but I'm just going to go ahead and tell you because there's more stuff in there for you to check out. If your line is stuck, make sure that instead of pulling direct back like a lot of us do when we break, Chip made a really cool idea or a suggestion. He said, walk down the beach 30 yards to your left and then 30 yards to your right. And what that should do is that should take that tab, whether you're on a Sputnik, Pyramid, anything really, and that should give you a little bit of wedge room from side to side and be able to get it back. So with all these going on like that, that is a pretty easy way to get your sinker back and your rig. So fun one.
I'm surprised Chip shared that one. I mean, if you're in the business of making and selling sinkers, pulling straight on them would be to your advantage, right? But that was a great tidbit he shared to try to get those unstuck. Yeah, so it looks like tomorrow night thunderstorms pretty much all day. Then it clears off. If anyone uses fishing points, that's a great, when you go click on the weather portion of fishing points, it actually breaks it down by hour for you. And Sunday we had overnight and it clears up. Monday it's like PM, it's calling PM showers here, but according to fishing points, it's like 9-10 o'clock. And then early morning, like we're talking 3-4, and then cleared out. So the rest of the day is going to be nice. Like I said, in the 60s and then sunny the rest of the week. So should be good. I plan on getting out doing some shark fishing these three nights, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday. I got some friends in town. And we're going to try to get them on a nice shark while they're here.
Well, keep that. Hopefully that the waves are low enough and you can get the fishing monster out there, the boat, get it out the past breakers and go have some fun.
Yeah, I hope so. I hope that north wind helps blowing it flat and getting us in there. Go ahead. I want to add this up here real quick. Let's see how loud this comes in.
Now, broke this, in the squall.
This was a good night.
He is on. We're going to apply a little pressure to him.
That was a good one.
What? Yeah. Get it.
Screaming.
Damn, that sounded. That was
I think we got something nice on here.
And you did. You really did.
Yeah.
Look at him manipulating that pressure, Jacob. He was definitely on the throttle very nicely on that shark.
That ended up being a nice about a 6-foot sandbar shark. Demo was out there with me that night and man, hit a half a whiting. And yeah, I'm with you, Carl. I want to make that a ringtone. That would definitely be a good ringtone.
The problem is you go into like Half Hitch or Emerald Coast or any of the tackle shops and you're like, hey, just call me and just see what happens.
Yeah. Man, everybody's head will start turning.
What was that?
What's going on there? Oh man.
Here we go. All right. So this is what I was going to tell you about another one. So one of the websites I found not too long ago, because I have that ringtone. That's a good one. So what I was playing with recently was Windy.com. Mm. And I hate the glare back. I'm sorry, guys. But the cool part is it kind of shows you how the wind direction is moving throughout the zones. So whenever you're playing the entire one, really good one to go with. And it also gives you the forecast as you start rolling through. It can show you as the days go on, you can see how the wind directions change hour by hour. We all care about the wind. The wind is one of those few factors that we all know is super important. You got to pay attention to. So anything you can get as a visual indicator can be a really good, big help. So if you've got other apps, by all means, throw them in the comments, guys and gals, sorry, everyone. Throw things that you're using. I mean, all it does is make everybody better. It helps everyone get on there. We've had some great ones. I mean, and the ultimate, make sure, and I say this every time with the best one, make sure you have fish rules on your phone. Thanks. You need that. That app is a good, it doesn't matter if you know the regulations back forth 7 days, Sunday. If something changed within 24 hours, that thing updates and it updates quick and it goes off your GPS. So I was fishing in Florida with Arrington last weekend, and then we switched over to Alabama. And it's like, hey, you're in Alabama. Don't forget, you know, your limits have changed. You get a 3 pompano, but you get 2 red, which I didn't get. But anyway, but it's still good to have that GPS factor to know what your rules are, where you're at. So pay attention to that. Important one to have.
Absolutely.
Magic seaweed. That's a good one,
Yeah, that's another good one too. Magic seaweed. Windy. Fishing points, I use that one a lot. And fish rules, they're right next to each other on my phone. And the FWC, so I can pull up my license when needed.
Yeah. Oh, that one's great. I love that.
That's another good one.
Yeah. You have your license? Oh, crap.
Wait a minute.
Let me
pull it up. We haven't mentioned much peer stuff on the show. One of the comments I got offline was, you know, great report, great, loving what you guys are doing, peer stuff. So this week I would throw some peer stuff in. We'll start with Navarre real quick. Back to share screen. Hang on. Let's get this in here. Share the screen. Tabs. One of these things says Navarre Fishing Report. There we go. Share. We'll bring that up. So here's today's report. If you guys haven't been here and follow them, the Navarre newspaper, they got the fishing reports on there. But fishing hours remain the same, open daily 6 to 9 out there. And Bonita have been the hot topic out there on the pier.
Yesterday,
Bonita and Bonnet Heads. And today, Bonita, Bluefish, and of course, Catfish. They're always out there. But it's good to see some Bonita. I know the shark guys, you know, looking for bait, can get out there and grab what they need. And then we'll go over to, since I'm not sharing the whole screen, I got a.
That's funny. Not too long ago, he's talking about the pier. Kyle from Half Hitch. He's that.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember his last name. I suck about that. He's author, all around great dude. He was catching, I think it was blackfin off the pier.
So really?
He brought some into Half Hitch for tuna.
That is nuts.
I would love to catch a tuna. I mean, I didn't realize they even came that close off the pier side.
No. So here we got Okaloosa Pier. So they're going to be changing their hours a little bit coming up next week. I think it is Tuesday. Mm-hmm. So they'll close at 7 for their employee party. And then Christmas Day, they'll be open 8 a.m. to 6. And then New Year's Eve, 5 to 9. And the beginning January 3rd, their new hours will be 7 to 7 until mid-January. And the same thing's going on there, too. But I like they got that nice tackle shop. I don't know if you've ever been out there, Brian.
The one right there when you walk on, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They got a nice setup there. We should do – wish Navarre had something as nice.
We just need to start – we just need to tell Amber, hey, look, you need to put a kiosk right there at the pier. I mean, the shop's on one side of the bridge. Just come on down.
Yeah. you know, for something that, you know, the longest pier in the Gulf, the longest pier in Florida, you'd think they'd have a nice tackle shop and everything set up right there for you to go out there and catch stuff. And
Eric got that Newport Richie. We'll make sure we add that one in on the next round. So we will get more on the pier, guys. Again, I think we'll find some people too that can contribute. By all means, all of you are welcome to throw in there on that one. I know some of you are diehard pier fishermen. And
yeah, if there's any of those guys, any of you pier guys on there that want to jump on and give us a good report, by all means, drop it in the comments, hit Brian or I up.
Love to have you on
social media, and we'll get you on there.
I'd love to fish the pier. I fished with you at the pier, and we went halfway down, and I was like, I'm good. I don't need to go to the octagon.
Yeah.
I'm angry.
I'm not an into the octagon guy. Mr. Brundage, what is up?
Oh, that would be a fun shop to run. Because the jokes would be endless. Like, you come back in, did you lose another one?
Yeah.
Just, give me the stupid lures.
That's right. Give me another gotcha. Come on. I need another gotcha.
Gotcha.
You want some steel leader this time? No.
No.
Oh, good.
I'll see
tell me how to fish. Exactly. Come on back, buddy.
Oh, man. So that, you know what? There's a business idea. Just need to sit out there one day, just hanging out with a bucket of lures. I'm like, oh, did you need, here? I got you.
Here.
I mean, something about illegal, but you know, what else?
Whatever. Here you go.
All right. So we got the offshore. No one reported for offshore. Unfortunately, we didn't get that one this week. Did reach out to a few, but some decent reports that I got from my neighbor. He's out on one of the charter boats all the time. They're still catching on the mingos, and they are still pulling up the red snappers. So if you're looking to get offshore, there are still very big on the charters. They're still running out very well with the party boats and the individual boats. So if you're looking to get out while you can. I mean, coming up on the new year, doesn't hurt. Don't forget moon phase.
We're gonna focus. It's looking pretty right now. At least, well, for nighttime fishing, it's looking great. Daytime fishing, like we talked last week, hit or miss.
Yep.
When you get out there, but it should be good for this week. Also, grouper season closes the end of the month, so your gags, get out there now. Especially in the bay. I had a couple reports of guys that pulled up some nice ones in the bay as well. So we only got a couple more days to get out there and try our spot and see if we can't get some gags up for the before the end.
Mr. Burford, good evening, sir.
Mr. Burford, over the bar rods. How are you, sir? Thanks for joining in with us tonight. Well, we're going to get right into our inshore report. Coming back this week, we got Captain Bill Lipscomb from E6 Inshore Fishing Adventures. Let's get him back at it to the stream. Captain Bill, how you doing, buddy?
I'm good. How are y'all?
You're bracketing Bill's
doing
face.
Well. Yeah, I know. Hey, boom. There we go. There we go. Just takes me a minute. I'm a one-man show here. No,
gotta love technology.
There we go. I know, right? It's awesome. So, Bill, what's changed since last week? What you been doing?
Went and did a little scouting mission at Garcon Point. And a lot of little fish. Uh-oh. A lot of fish. We've seen a lot of fish on the bottom machine, but not a lot of eaters. We caught some mangroves, all small. Caught a few white trout. Actually caught a few whiting, which was kind of different.
Yeah.
And I caught a big old 29-inch redfish on a piece of cut bait with a sheephead hook.
Oh,
a small little hook?
Light, very, very light sheephead hook, like a crappie hook.
Wow.
And then when I got him in the boat, I pulled the hook out. I pulled the hook out with my fingers, and it was like barely in there.
What?
It was crazy. But then I caught about a 40-pound black drum on a Meridine in a canal.
In a canal.
I sight fished him.
Whoa.
Wow.
With a Meridine.
I was like, oh my God, this really happened.
Dang, man.
I saw him. I'm like, hey, looky there. My buddy's like, whoa, wow. So I just I just pitched it over there and I watched it drift down and I seen him come out and he turned on it. And I'm like, I think he's going to eat that. I twisted it one time. And he just engulfed it. And I don't know if y'all ever caught a big black drum like that. 40, 50 mm-hmm. pounds. Mm-hmm. But when you set the hook on those and you're only like 5 feet from it, it feels like you hooked a 55-gallon drum full of water.
Yeah, exactly. I'm gonna see. Did that come up on the?
That was the redfish that I caught.
There it goes. Yeah, I know I had you on here somewhere. So let's go back here. Which one am I sharing? I think it's this one. Yeah. So that's the redfish that you had.
Yep.
Big old, and there he is, right there.
Oh dang!
That is a monster. And on the Meridine, there he is, right there.
Yeah, we took a picture for posterity. Yeah. As you know, that don't happen very often.
Yep. Pictures or it didn't happen.
But it happened.
Yep.
I'm good. I'm here to tell you.
Nice job, man.
That is awesome.
Hell of a fish.
Yeah, it was definitely interesting. I thought he was going to pull me around a canal, but he really didn't. So it was kind of nice. He's kept diving down and coming back up and diving back down. So it was kind of nice. And then he was released without harm. So he was all right. Good.
Awesome.
Yeah. I know when we catch them in the surf, it's you get maybe two big runs and then it's just like you said, it's pulling in a 55-gallon drum of water. Yep. He just lays there and you drag him on in.
Well, he fought me for a while, probably 20 minutes.
Oh,
yeah.
Long
in the canal. I was like, this guy's got to give up sometime. I certainly am not.
Right. Right.
But the bite was really, really slow. The fish were kind of grabbing the tail and they wasn't like really committing to a whole lot. I don't know if that had anything to do with the weather, incoming weather or what. It was a beautiful day. It was flat, almost flat calm most of the day. We actually went looking for a sheephead and fished around quite a few pylons at the bridge and never did get a bite on a sheephead that we know of. Never hooked up on one. So maybe we did. I don't know.
Criminals. Yeah,
that's a very finesse bite.
Yeah. But in the canals, the speckled trout are up in the canals.
Okay.
Almost every canal around here has speckled trout in it right now. Now, they may not be real big. You might try fishing them at night under a lighted dock with this full moon. They're probably in there thick.
Yeah, just in there gorging.
But the rest of the fish should be moving up into the river by now.
Okay. Gotcha.
And so with this weather, I don't know. It's been crazy. I have a buddy call me yesterday. Hey, you want to go out tomorrow? Like tomorrow? And I'm like, no. It's gonna be raining all day. I'm not gonna get pneumonia.
Right?
Yeah. I'm like, I'm not getting pneumonia. He's like, what? You got rain gear? And I'm like, yeah, but no.
Exactly.
But I hear you. We fished with live shrimp most of the day. Not a whole lot of anything other than what I said. But there was probably 9 boats out there. Didn't look like people were really lighting the world on fire, but there was a few fish caught that I saw, but mostly white trout.
Any you notice any schools of redfish or anything that may have looked like a school, but you just didn't run over and investigate or anything?
I saw one that was on the way back. It was like halfway between the bridge and East Bay. It's just a big water push. And I actually slowed down and we were kind of out of time and had to get back, but it was going to start getting dark. And I don't know if you've ever came into East Bay, into East River.
I wasn't going to stay where you were at, but the pictures looked telling coming out of the creek.
And then
coming in. And I was like, man, that's, if you were coming back in there at night, that's a shallow area.
It ain't, you're not careful. Well, you got to know where you're going.
Right.
But if you would have come, if I didn't have GPS and you were running back there at night, you'd probably run right into the cattails and whatnot down there.
Yep. Yep.
But we got in just before dark and everything was cool.
Awesome. Well, that's great, man. Appreciate you coming on with us again this week.
Awesome. Giving us a great report. Anytime.
We're going to be taking a break the next 2 weeks. We won't have captains on. It'll just be Brian and I for Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve. Reports will be on real quick, but we'll be back with you.
Well, I hope that Brian has a Santa Claus hat or something he can wear.
Everybody's making reference of your
the head there, man. Apparently, I mean, I need to not shower when I get home from work.
He's the only guy that doesn't want to wear a hat on here. I don't know.
Well, that's true. That's true.
Every time I've worn it the last few times, it's like this. It's like some weird specter vision. It just don't look right, man.
Bill, Merry Christmas to you.
Have Merry a good Christmas New Year. To y'all, and hopefully we'll keep doing this. And
yes, sir.
I'll get out and get some more reports for you guys.
Sounds good. Awesome. Bill.
Appreciate it, bud.
You can hit up Frank for some more info.
There you go. Great report, man. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
See ya. Cliff. So backing into the comments here, Cliff, the big ones that Tom and he caught last year at Fort Pickens. I remember those ones. I think I remember the text thread that day.
The redfish?
They got their two monster reds.
Oh.
And I think they also got the two big black drums right after that, too. But they were further down from us, and yeah, they were crushing it in there. I have rain gear, but I want to gear. Yeah, it's because I have it doesn't mean I want to use it.
Right.
Water temperature here, if I'm not mistaken, was 68. Where are you?
Was it today? Yeah, I thought it was upper 60s.
I closed that one.
Hey, so while you're looking for that,
57,
I
57 today.
Six,
I was one off.
57?
67.
Six seven. Gotcha. Yeah, that makes sense. Which is good. Right. We're right in that zone. We're right in that zone. That's exactly right.
Yep.
Awesome.
Okay. All right. So go ahead. Unless we're moving on. I don't know what you want to do.
I was gonna say, while you were looking for that, last week's episode, we hit 3,700 reaches, which means it came up in front of 3,700 people, and we have almost 1,000 views from last week's episode. So that's all thanks to you guys that are watching, sharing it out, getting it out in front of folks, and talking about it. And we greatly appreciate it. If we want this thing to grow, it's going to take a little while, but, That was awesome. That surprised me when I saw the insights for last week's show. So
actually,
please keep. Doesn't surprise you? Nah, it's all good.
We're fucking awesome, man.
That's right. Man, that's true. We are.
Jeremiah. That's right. He caught one tonight and had it for dinner an hour later. Nothing like fresh seafood, man. Can't go wrong with fresh fish that way. That is good stuff right there. All right. Okay, so moving into the fun stuff. Chip, you're awesome.
You're awesome, buddy.
Oh, come on now. Hey, if you guys haven't, we're running out of time if you guys haven't done this yet. And if you're looking for Chip Sinkers, I know he had a sale going not too long ago, so go over to his webpage, take a look. There is some stuff to go. And, I mean, somebody's got to be cool. I want somebody to order the bucket of sinkers. I mean, I would do it.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a little tight on dollars right now.
Yeah.
But the bucket of sinkers was totally cool. I love that idea.
Yeah, it's Chip. You still visiting? Out visiting? I noticed you didn't like Whole Food chicken. Had an issue with it.
Nothing's good at Whole Foods.
He was like, "This thing is dry." He said it was drier than the turkey on Christmas vacation. That's what it was.
That was a good one, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, New York.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're going to rock into the surf report here. This week we've got Mr. Perdido Blaine coming to us. He's going to give us his setup there. He's got a lot of good information. Blaine, what's up, buddy?
Listen, guys. I didn't know Chip and Mark and everybody was going to be here, man. I would have cleaned myself up a bit if I knew North Florida was watching. I'm here in my pajamas.
Hey, man, you never know what's going to happen on this show.
That.
What's going on, fellas?
What's up, buddy?
Okay. All right. What you got for us in the surf, sir?
Surf, man. It's been the bull donkeys. I've hooked up on four big drum. We've got two on the beach. Pompano rigs and fish bites, man. And I'm running big boy rods. I'm running big boy rods with bigger hook, bigger setups on them, cut bait. And they're not touching it. They want to hit my 10-foot rods with the 4,000s on them. with, you know, with pompano rigs, man.
Which is a little piece of fish bite.
Dude, like pompano setup.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I pulled two on the beach, I believe it was Sunday, and one was a tank, bro. Biggest one I've ever caught. Biggest one I've ever caught. And then yesterday went back out. I had a unscheduled PTO day. My internet was down, so I dipped. I couldn't work. Yeah. You know, can't work.
Work.
So I dipped, and I got down there about noon, and it was slow. And moved spots, you know, gave it about an hour, moved spots. And I, once I moved, I started getting on some whitings, and then another big boy hit, man. And same thing, 10 foot rod, 4,000 reel, little piece of fish bite. And we had some chop yesterday for the first time. First time since I've been out there. It's been flat all week, man.
Yeah.
And I think Wednesday we started kind of getting that southeast push a little bit. It chopped it up around here. So I was able to take advantage of that yesterday. And he got off on me, man. He pulled the hook. Ooh. I mean, I seen him.
Yeah.
I seen him. I'm heading there. And he pulled the hook on me, man. But decent size whiting around here. They've been a trend of like 13 inches. It seems like that's what I've been catching, little 13s. I got one little pomp, but I got Jordan right next to me, G2. He's had a couple of great days.
He has. With
a pompano, you know? Yeah. And now I'm here in Navarre. So I'm like right in the middle. And like what you guys were talking about last week, you know, it had me curious, man. After I watched this last week, I went back and looked because there was a couple weekends that me and Arrington got on some nice-sized pomp. And I knew it was after the summer. And so I went back and looked at my videos, and it was the end of September. It was two weekends in a row. Me and Anderson were out here pulling in 3-pounders. And then it was just, they've been ghost. And now they're showing back up again. So it's like, yeah, what are they doing?
Yeah.
Are they running out and coming back in? Or you know what I mean? So that had me curious when you guys were talking about it last night or last week. And I went back and looked because I was like, I know me and Arrington were getting on them. And I knew it was like beginning of fall. But looking at the videos, it was late September, you know? So I don't know, man. They got me confused this year, bro.
What are your predictions for the next couple weeks here? What are you thinking?
Oh, yeah. They're looking plentiful. Like I said, man, they're banging in Gulf Shores, and you guys are pulling that in the barn. I just got to get out there on the right day.
Now, what gets in the way of that?
I'm grounded all weekend. Wife will be out of town, so I'm on Thunder duty. So you know how that goes, man.
Oh, come on. Thunder's your lucky charm in the water.
Every time I take Thunder fishing, I'm like, it's my last time. Last time I'm taking him.
All right. What are you recommending for baits for this next run for the surf?
You know, man, I start everything with fish bites just to get lines in the water, and I switch it up as I go. I've been doing my little pomp burgers, which the idea came to me from the Finding Demo with Rich. The pomp burgers, man, I've been making them. Yep. I've been doing the piece of fish bites, the fresh dead, and another piece of fish bites, and make a little sandwich. And I got a couple hits on those yesterday. Sand fleas are hard right now. And the water is still okay where you can get in the rake, you know. It's not too cold for me yet. It's getting there. But I can still take my shoes off and splash around there and rake, but they're hard to find. I know Jordan down there, he's used a ghost shrimp. That's a ghost shrimp king over there, Jordan, man. Yeah. I don't know how he gets all this. But I think he actually said that he was using salted shrimp over there in Gulf Shores these last few pumps that he caught today.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it might be definitely something to keep in mind.
Salting works sometimes. I mean, I'm still a fan of it. I know several people aren't, but on the same one, you know, I've found that fresh dead, yes, you're going to have a better hookup, but it's not bad to have some salted in there. Not to be like salted clams, all that
stuff. As soon as I see something that looks tasty, I did the whole Diet Pepsi shrimp thing for like a month. I watched that video. I was like, I'm doing that. And it worked.
Yeah.
I just got lazy. Yeah.
Well, I mean, it's also, I mean, with, and I think we said this too in the other podcast, especially, I think actually Chip and I talked about it, but you know, with winter fishing coming up, you got to change your game up with the baits. You got to have that bigger, bigger range of things available. It's not like their summer or our spring run where, hey, you know what? I could throw a sand flea out, you know, and just get after it. Having everything is always important to get there. Have some shrimp, have some clam. I love bringing crab knuckles. Like after Chip showed it to me, I was like, yeah, I always have it. But having that myriad is just going to make it even better in the surf. It's always good to have that, because if you go out with one, you're, I mean, you're a one-legged man and you're just not going to win it.
Yeah. And even the variety of setups, you know. So I'm like, wintertime, I got like two whiting rods, which might be 7-foot rods, you know, two little whiting rods, two pompano rods, you know, pompano setups, and then two big boy rods, I call them big boy rods, you know, with the, I use K-Pomps slatter rigs, big game rigs. They're about a size 4 circle hook with a pyramid on them. And I got two of those out for cut bait, you know, so I'm really fishing for three different things of what I want. Oh, and I was going to say too, the catfish have been scarce around here. I've maybe won a trip, which is beautiful.
You know, you want to put that out in the universe, man.
Yeah,
you want to put that out there.
Nowhere. I was like...
You just created that. I hope you know that.
Yeah,
you just
exactly.
Rocked. So, I mean, shrimp, you know how they are, man. You throw some shrimp out there, that's the first thing you're going to hook up. But, yeah, man, I haven't seen them.
I was fishing with Tony a couple weeks ago, and he had a great idea and a great analogy for the catfish. You know, it's like at nighttime, they're zombies. They just come up out of the sand, and they're just there all of a sudden. It's going to eat all your stuff. They're just, that's all it is. It's just dead pompano that are coming back to pay us back for everything. So,
and as far as reports in Perdido with pompano, I've had a couple guys got on like maybe one a trip, you know, legal. So they definitely, I haven't seen any numbers here, man. No numbers, just those big boys. And those are fun, you know, especially in the beginning, you know, but I know they're going to get old. Like there's another one. I got to spend the next 15 minutes getting this guy in, you know, but at the beginning of the season, you're like, yeah, man, here we go. Yeah.
Cliff, you were there for that conversation. That was a good, that was a funny conversation. That was a good laugh for a good 10 minutes. All right. Lane, any last thoughts for the show this week? Anything you want to throw out there for anyone to get anything, go for it.
No, man, this is great, man. I'm glad you guys are doing this, man. I feel honored you guys brought me on. And keep it up, brothers.
Hey, Blaine, before you go, if anybody, how does people get in touch with you if they want to book a trip or whatever, your social media, how do they find you?
Perdido Blaine, everything. Website, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, everything's under Perdido Blaine. DM me. I'm good about responding. So through Facebook or Instagram, either one. I'm a little slow with the emails that come through Perdido Blaine just because it's so slow. I never check them, you know?
Right.
So just straight DM me, man. And you know, I'll answer any questions or chat or whatever.
Awesome.
Speaking of that, before he goes, Blaine, love the last YouTube video with the casting, man. That was really smart. Good knowledge that you passed out there about that.
You know who I got that idea? It was Chip.
Yeah.
Chip was telling me that he used to throw at hula hoops in the water. I was like, what? And I was like, it's a great idea. But then I was like, yeah, I don't want to chase hula hoops all day. I'm going to draw a circle in the sand.
I like it.
Make it easier.
Awesome. All right, buddy.
Well, man, great report. Guys,
listen, man, it was an honor, bro. I'll talk to y'all this week.
Sounds good, man.
All right.
Awesome. Great report. Blaine, he's a hoot.
Was.
Getting him on here, man.
He is.
when we contacted, you know. What's that?
No, you go. You were on a roll there.
I said when we contacted him, you reached out to him and everything to get him on here, and that was great. And it's just a great addition to the rest of our group that we got.
Yeah.
Got some quality panhandle fishermen here, I'm telling you guys.
And a few characters.
And a few characters. Good stuff.
Oh, man. All right. So are you doing the scroll or am I doing the scroll?
I got a few things to show. So if I don't hit what you want to show, then we'll go and roll
Send
that way.
It.
Let's see here. We're going to share. I guess I'll just do the screen, the entire screen.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, maybe. I got everything shut down, I think. Make it easy.
We don't look at anyone else's tabs.
Oh, infinite. What we got there? That's us. That's Mr. Bill, Navar. What we got here? So this is
that
Mr. Eric Dunn today in Navar. And they don't look small. Those are some nice pompano.
That little post right there caused a bit of a frenzy from what I remember.
That post right there did?
Because all of a sudden the text group exploded. Hey, limit was happened. Limit happened. Everyone out.
That's true. And surf conditions weren't, I mean, they looked great. It looks more redfishy to me than pompanoid, but hey, I'm glad to see that you're there. Hopefully everybody gets on them this weekend.
Absolutely. Oh, I lost my stupid tab.
Uh-oh. That's all right. You keep looking for it. I got more to show.
Oh, please do.
Redfish, there we go, have been what's out in the surf this week. Redfish and black drum, as you heard from Blaine's report, but definitely some monster redfish. This guy, Scott Watson, looks like a fellow Marine Corps vet there from Georgia. But he tore him up. This was number two, I think.
Yeah.
And
he was after it.
This was his first one. And I was like, holy cow. That is a nice redfish. You know, that's looking easy. 40 inches.
Oh,
easy.
Easily.
40 inches plus. That is an awesome catch.
What did he use on that? What did he have? Oh, that's a scale.
Yeah, that was the scale. It doesn't even say. I think if you go down, I think he was using cut mullet.
I think it was. I think it was live. Fresh cut.
Yeah. More redfish going on. Since I had so many tabs, every one of the messages is going to pop up there. But another redfish, Tommy Eaton there. I think this was caught at Pickens, if I'm not mistaken, in and around that area.
40 incher on the dot.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Jordan.
Another G2. Man, tearing it up over there. Yeah. And their limit's a little different. They do total length over there, isn't it, in Alabama?
Yep. Yeah. Yeah, not to the fork, total length.
Yep. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. So that's a nice legal fish there for him. Go back. There he is there. But that's a nice catch for the day. That's a limit of pompano in Alabama, which is three. So great job there.
Couple combat whiting. Nice.
Yeah. Yeah. And there's Jordan with his catch there. He had two days. This is just one. But he's had a couple great days. And they got nice looking surf over there too. I'd like to get over there and fish that area because they have like a nice deep trough, it looks like, and a nice distinct first bar, if you will, like what I would consider the first bar right there, where my cursor's going. So that nice deep trough there, I mean, that's an excellent fishing area.
I don't think Jordan would be sad if we came and visited.
No, I don't think so either. And so if catching sheephead wasn't hard enough, my man here does a double up. He said, if you're not dropping two crabs down at once, you might as well just stay home. Like, look at that. That looks like Sykes. I don't know if he said that's where he were, but I think this was from the Pensacola Fishing Fanatics site. So
doesn't look like
that. I think it looks like Sykes a little bit right there. I don't know. Yeah. Maybe not. I don't know.
Meh.
And this one, I wanted to give a shout out. This is definitely America right here. But the Wildlife Sanctuary of Northwest Florida is looking for fish. They have birds of prey out there. So the eagles, the ospreys, things like that, that would love fish. They're open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5. They're located at 105 North Street over there in Pensacola. And they will take any and all fish that you bring them. White trout, you know, they're plentiful. If you got a boat and you're out fishing around the bridges and stuff, they'll take white trout. I'm sure they'll take whiting. They'll take anything they can get really to help rehab and work with these animals and get these birds back and going. And they just need some help with some food. So I saw this out there. I thought that was a great post. And anything we can do to help conservation and getting them guys some food, we should take advantage of and do.
I love when the screen does that. It's like the ultimate mirror back and
forth. Oh, yeah. It just kept going. Yeah.
No, you hit the majority of any kind of the scrolls there. Demo, you and the Eagles can share a catfish. You ain't going to let it go. Yeah. I'll go live. I will go live and eat that one thing.
And I think we should just go out one night. We'll catch a mess of them.
Yeah.
We'll clean them up, and we'll just do a catfish fry. Me, you, Justin, the group. You know what I mean? Yeah. We'll just all get together.
Fine.
And we'll hang out and eat catfish and go live with it.
When I get there, week catch my number 7-pound pompano with my green rigs. I'll let everyone take pictures with me.
Get to hang out with Cliff.
Can't wait. I'm looking forward to Cliff getting back. And hey, like we talked about last time too with Cliff, when he gets back into town, he's got some rigs coming out. So pay attention to that. You'll probably see something coming up. We'll probably have some fun stuff for you guys to run. Jacob, hey, yeah, come to Navarre, man. Eventually we will get this set up. I know I've got a plan to shut down my business here in a couple days so I can go on for 2 weeks vacation. So,
Jacob, if you're going to come all the way out here, you're not just going to watch us eat it. You're going to have to partake in eating some catfish. I mean, it's catfish, man. I mean, I did a video of eating Blue Runner. I mean, they're not bad.
I liked it.
Yeah, it was good.
I didn't have a problem the night I ate Blue Runner. I was like, what's the problem with this fish? It's fine.
Right. Exactly. Sometimes you got to do what you got to do.
Backing up into the comments earlier, kind of brought up something to me. I don't eat catfish. I was going back through the memories. You get your daily Facebook memories. This month has been a crazy one for memories of fishing. Last, Justin and I had our epic day. Big pomp, mm-hmm. big reds. Abby caught her first red. That was another one. And then I noticed we were just last year around this time was you, Jeremiah, Justin and I. We were all down at Portofino, and Jeremiah caught his first Bitten Ugly that day.
I remember that day. Yeah.
Then after that, we were all catching. It was right at December. Everyone started nailing the big black drums. Kyle, for a while, he had his video out where he had it with the mm-hmm. drone. You could see the fight. December's just that time where those big ones come running back to closer to shore.
That was the same time. Is it Ryan Smith? No, Casting Assassin.
Yeah.
Ryan. Yeah. His son caught the big sheephead.
That's right.
From the beach was December.
Yeah.
As well. Because they were out there. Yep. Because they were out there doing a big black drum. Like Fort Pickens was the place to go for drum from about Portofino down.
Yeah.
All the way down there to Pickens was huge for black drum last year.
Yeah, it was hot. It was real hot fishing right there around the inlet. It was kind of surprising how quickly things had progressed down and just in that zone. But hey, you know, winter fishing, like we always said, and you guys, if you know, you've been here for a while, you know, winter fishing is tough. It sucks, but you know, it's also that fun time too to try and change it up, play some new games. Like Bernito said, he heard in my podcast the burger I got from Kelly Musson down on the East Coast there. He went fish gum and then a piece of shrimp or something there. And then either another piece of fish gum or a fish bite, he would hit all three just to get the scent profile out there. And the dude, he just kill it, limiting it out, crushing it just that way. Brilliant knowledge. But again, is that something we normally do in the spring? No, not really needed, but here it's a little bit different of a game. And if I'm not mistaken,
I was going to say, there's somebody with us that fishes with us that does a similar sandwich with fish gum and fish bites and does very well with it.
He does.
And if he's listening, he'll jump in and put a comment. But when you ask him, would you catch it on fish gum or fish bites? He looks at you and goes, yep.
Yep.
And we're like, no, come on, man. What would you catch it on? He's like, no, seriously. I put both of them on a hook and I threw it out there and that's what caught it. And I'm like, and it goes back to Kelly's comment of just getting that flavor profile out there, anything that's going to get the scent in the water to start dispersing quickly to attract the fish, boom, and you're in there.
Yep. And don't forget, with the water temperatures also being cooler, you've also got like the fish gum and fish bites. They last, the scent profile is a little bit longer lasting sentences together, words. Fish bites also has their winter recipe. I believe they have this other scent releasing one. And somebody had mentioned, I can't remember who told us about it, and I feel horrible. I don't think I'm letting out a secret here, but the quick release for the wintertime is one of the better options on that one because it is colder. It holds a little bit more. a little bit longer. Somebody had said that, but I can't remember who it was.
Yeah. You're talking the fish bites. The red package fish bites for the cold water scent. Yeah. It gets out there and it gets it out quicker.
Right.
But I still, I mean, to me, I only leave it on for about 20 minutes, if that. Yeah. You know, that's bait change. And then just instinctively, okay, if I haven't gotten anything, then I'm automatically baiting back up and putting fresh on and trying something different.
That Chip got me broken off on that idea, because every time when I went fishing with him that one time, when he bring it in, he cut it off and put on new ones. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
New bait. Duh.
Right.
Oh, crap. But it's I mean, I get it now. I mean, 20-30 minutes, that's really my ideal time for a bait change. Justin and I started doing something a couple times when we went out. If we weren't getting anything in the first 30, we were starting to leapfrog poles further down.
Yeah.
3 hours.
Jeremiah, and we called him out on this already, so I'll put it out here. But he's the only guy I know that leaves his bait on, puts his rods up, takes them home, comes back to fish a week later, and then throws them right back out there. And hooks up with fish. Like,
and that's to the
testament of that bait that he uses. And he'd just throw it out there and let it go. So
fish bites last a long time. I've noticed fish gum now lasting way longer than normal. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I noticed that with the last that last pack of Pump Party lasted quite a bit longer. I don't know if it was a change or if it was just the water temperature, but if bait lasts, I mean, everyone's got their little tricks. You know, fish it till it dies. I remember fishing with, hell, you've done it too, fishing with our fish bites until it's mesh. It is what it is.
There's sometimes when we're hanging, it depends. So and Blaine, we'll get him back on here next time and ask him about it too. But when you're a guide and you're trying to get clients on fish, if you're telling me the bait the optimal time for a bait is only 15 to 20 minutes, then that's all I'm going to fish it, and I'm going to put fresh bait on to try to get clients on fish. I'm not going to leave it out there any longer. Now, there have been times where it's out there and all you see is the rod tip just tapping, and clients want to run over and start reeling right away. And you're like, no, buddy, wait a minute. You bring it in because they're not hooked. This is a little catfish or the little whiting that are pecking it out. And then those are the times that, you know, 10 minutes later you reel it in and all you got is the mesh on there because they picked everything else off.
Yeah.
So, you know, out of habit is what drives that 15, 20 minutes. Okay. Bait change. Unless we're just sitting out there bullshitting, it's just whatever.
Yeah.
And it's just us out there, you know.
That's been known to happen once in a while.
Yeah, once or twice.
I've gotten to the habit now where I set a timer on my phone. I've been called out, like, really? You got a timer? Yes, I have a timer, because I have the worst case of squirrel, and you all have seen that on this show. But I'm always just like, nope, gotta do it.
old Chip says he's caught a lot of fish. I'm gonna put this up here.
And I believe it.
The mesh. Yeah.
That's the worst part, is I believe it.
Yeah. That's another guy. Yeah. We, you know, Brian and I both have had the pleasure of fishing with Chip out on the, out in Jacksonville area. And the guy will get you on the fish. He will put you where they're at. And he will get you on them. It's a great time going out there. We got to get out there again.
Yeah, we do. Well, there's that tournament coming up. So if any of you are interested in traveling, there is a tournament in Jacksonville in March. It is Roy's. I fished it last year. It was it was an interesting learning experience for that. But still, you know, fishing community is always fun. If you can do some travel fishing, definitely a good time. Chip will eventually come over here. We will find a way to bribe him, whatever it takes. Well, he's going to come over here. He's talked about it before. Dad and Bruno himself is a dangerous fisherman. Royce is not Jack's. That's right, Mark. I'm sorry.
Is that further down?
I think Jack's
further down than.
It's in between south of Jacksonville, but it's almost to my mom's in Orlando, but it's north of Canaveral. Oh, God. I can't remember what it's called. I just drive.
Yeah.
We've never pushed it for an hour without a bait check. Yeah, okay. Oh, good times there.
We do need to get Chip over here though.
He's on.
Probably not now. Wintertime fishing's tough. If you're gonna make the drive over, we want it to be worth your while to get over here.
Well, the worst part would be he would come here in the winter. We'd bring him to one of the areas like, well, we might catch here because it's been rough. And all of a sudden he's going to limit out. And we're just gonna be like, of course.
Yeah.
Of course. New Smyrna. Thank you, Mark. I apologize. You thank you so much. Oh, yeah. Man, that was good times.
Definitely.
A couple weeks ago, he said he was coming this way soon. All right.
Yeah. Nice.
And big tournament next spring. I will go to that one with you again. Yeah, you had a
heck yeah.
There was a really good one that Mike and I went to that we were just talking about. Went to Fish Pike's headquarters. It was fun. I mean, it was different.
It was a good tournament.
It was fun.
Yeah, it'll definitely test you going over there and fishing an area like that where you have a 100-yard tidal swing that you're messing with, and it's just. It was crazy. And Chip told us too. He's like, where you're casting right now is where you'll be casting from in about 3 hours. And then he had to leave to go take care of some stuff for the tournament. And then sure enough, the water just kept leaving Brian and I, and we had adjusted. And then all the swimmers came in and then we just,
that was Ben's,
packed it up and left.
Mark, yeah, thank you. That was Ben. And I've heard good news on that one. I've seen some posts on that. So hopefully that was a fun tournament. That was a good one. I don't know why I think they all run together, man. I suck. Mm-hmm. I'm hurting tonight. I'm sorry. But that was, that was a good time. Definitely the first time I've ever driven on the beach. That was a different experience. That was cool.
Yeah. It was fun. Good time. Well, we are at almost an hour again. So
Jeremiah, how do you cut your fish gum? I like inch and a half strip and cut in half. Tom showed me this bites. I do smaller, thicker chunks. It depends on the day for me. I do triangles on fish gum, and fish bites I do pinky nail slivers. You?
Yeah, fish bites I cut diamonds.
You do diamonds.
So I do diamonds out of the strip, and I'll cut diamonds maybe an inch long, 3/4 inch long, not very big. And then for my fish gum, I'll cut maybe inch to inch and a half strip, just straight out of the width of the package, and then I'll cut that in half sometimes, depending on what I'm going after.
Like it's a thinner strip.
Yep, like a thinner strip. And then double hook that, especially when I'm like, if I'm only targeting whiting, that's the way I'll cut my fish gum. And if I'm after pompano, then I'll just cut smaller, bigger squares and then loop that together. But always double it over right now, especially with the fish gum, not with the fish bites, but the fish gum, I always double it over because there's not as tight a mesh in there sometimes. Yeah. And with certain packages, it dissipates quicker than others. And then, so you want to make sure it stays on the, you want to make sure it stays there on the hook. So.
Tom, triangles resemble coquina clams. That's where I got the idea from. I think it was you, Tom, and mentioned that. I only do 1 inch for fish bites and cut fish gum in half, 1 inch pieces. 1 inch seems to be the key. Okay. Heard saw a good one. The fish bites, the pre-cuts, the tapereds. There's a guy, he did it on YouTube not too long ago.
Oh, hey, what's up, Taylor? What's up, Taylor?
He cut the tail end. And he snipped it in half to make it kind of a little petal.
I was getting ready to say that, because that's why I cut them in a diamond form or diamond shape. And then I'll cut a slit in that diamond. So those, it looks like two little tails. If you have any sort of current or anything going out there to, some sort of attractant.
Yeah. Hey. Whatever works, man. I mean, it's one of the reasons I like, I know we're running out of time here coming up on 60, but A1A, he's got that little teaser with the diamond. He's already got the diamond on it, and it's got a little bit more. That was a little fun add to that. Kind of like, all right, I'm just gonna throw bait on, so I didn't have to do the cut. That was a cool little trick.
Yeah, it's George Harris down there in A1A Surf Tackle, I think it is. Surf and Jetty. Yep, there you go. But he's got that little rig that's got that teaser on there. That's done quite well. That's what Jack caught his permit on up here. Was an A1A Jetty.
Oh, really?
That was last December as well. December 14th, I think it was. That was the only other permit that I've seen. I've seen a few other, but not many permit up here. So,
yeah,
it was interesting to catch that.
Yeah, it's been cool to see a few people catching on those. Mark, I like to figure out what flavor fish bites is working in match.
Hmm.
Oh, and match the fresh bait.
Oh, yeah, so okay. I've seen that a couple times. As so if shrimp's working, then they'll match it with shrimp and shrimp fish bites, or crab with crab fish bites on there. I mean, that's just double the scent, double the, you know, if the crab knuckle gets eaten off, then you got the white crab. Like I like to use the white crab up here. But that works really good.
Blaine just mentioned on the side here, I got a text, Telmark electric chicken and green shrimp. Electric chicken's been on it lately. I'll give it that. I've been catching a lot on those. Double the flavor, double the fun.
Somebody should do a commercial about that.
Such a great tagline.
That's a great tagline right there. But yeah, electric chicken has been on fire up here. That's what everyone's been hitting on. If you're using fish bites, and that's electric chicken.
Using sand fleas as live bait, I use with fish bites and fish gum as a small diamond after the sand flea. Well, cap it that way versus backwards.
Yeah, I do it the other way for some.
Yeah. I might have to try it that way. If it holds onto the thing a little bit better with my, well, no, I just rip the ass end out of the damn sand flea every time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Free food. Eat up fishy. All right.
Well, guys, it's we're just over an hour, so we're gonna wrap it up. Appreciate everybody tuning in tonight. We actually kept all the viewers. I mean, we stayed right around, you know, the same number the whole time. So that was awesome.
We appreciate you guys hanging out for the full hour and interacting with us. It's a lot of fun. We hope you guys enjoy these, because hey, it's a fun conversation. There's some knowledge coming out, and you know, it's always good for a little bit of time.
Because we're gonna do it either way. It just, you know, Brian and I are gonna be on here talking fishing, whether people are watching or not. So it's a good time. But like I mentioned earlier, we won't have folks on next week. It'll just be Brian and I for New Year's Eve and Christmas Eve. We'll do a quick jump on and say a few things and then head out, so everybody can enjoy time with family and friends. And then we'll be back after the new year with captains and giving reports and everybody else. So again, continue to share it, continue to put it out there. We love seeing this thing grow. We hope it grows, and couldn't do it without all of you guys. So appreciate it. Yep.
All right. See you next week, everybody. Have a great night.
We're out.